Okay. Organic chemistry. So what are we going to study in organic chemistry? We'll study about hydrocarbons, right? What are hydrocarbons? Hydrocarbons and its derivative. This is what we are going to study in organic chemistry, about hydrocarbons and its derivative, right? What are hydrocarbons? Hydrocarbons are the compounds of carbon and hydrogen. The names are it, right? Hydro is for hydrogen, carbon is carbon, right? So, in organic chemistry, we are going to discuss about hydrocarbons and its derivative, right? For example, you see alkane. Alkane is an example of hydrocarbon, yes? What is the general formula of alkane? CN H2N plus 2, right? One example we can take, which is ethane, CH3CH3. This is one hydrocarbon, because the organic compound contains only carbon and hydrogen into this, right? If one of the hydrogen here is replaced by any other group or atom, suppose CH3CH2, and one hydrogen is going to be replaced by OH, or if you write CH3CH2, CN. Any other compounds also we can write, okay? So these two compounds are what? These two are the derivative of this hydrocarbon, right? Derivative of this hydrocarbon. This is known as hydroxy derivative of ethane. This is halo or chloro derivative of ethane. The general name is halo derivative of ethane, right? This compound is alkyl halide. The general name is alkyl halide, okay? Alkyl halide. And this one is alcohol. The general name is alcohol. Similarly, we can have aldehyde present over here. We can have ketone also, right? We can have esters possible. All those compounds we are going to study in organic chemistry, correct? We are going to discuss about alkanes, physical chemistry, preparation and properties of alkanes, alkenes, preparation and properties, alkynes, preparation and properties, alcohol, preparation and properties. So basically all the compounds that we see in organic chemistry, the entire syllabus is about what? Preparation and properties, okay? Now when preparation and properties are concerned, so there are only reactions, okay? We have chemical reactions. And chemical reactions will have its own, mechanism. Mechanism means what? How the reaction is proceeding. Step-by-step description of any reaction, okay? What are the intermediates involved? How the intermediates are getting stable in the reaction. What are the various factors we have which stabilizes intermediate, right? So stable intermediate gives you major product, okay? Unstable intermediate gives you minor product, okay? So stability of intermediate, how to decide that, we have already discussed in GOC. What are the various intermediates we have? We have carbocation, carbonion, free radical, right? Benzene, nitrines also we have. Nitrines and carbons we'll discuss in specific chapters, okay? In what all reactions are involved, these kind of free radicals, correct? So, this is the thing we are going to discuss in organic chemistry. So, first of all, the naming of organic compound we'll see. And this comes under nomenclature, okay? Naming of organic compound. Organic compounds. So before going into the IUPAC nomenclature of organic compounds, there are two, three things we have to understand first. Okay.
This is the nomenclature chapter.
Yes, nomenclature. Okay, nomenclature and isomerism we'll discuss after this. Okay. There are two, three things we have to understand. First of all, the first thing is the representation of molecules. The representation of molecules. There are three different ways through which the molecules can be represented. The first one you write down. The first one is dash formula. Dash formula, condensed formula, and bond line structure. Okay. The first one is dash formula. Dash formula. Okay, so the first suppose the examples you are taking is CH3 or C2H6. C2H6 is thin, right? So this molecule we can represent as carbon-carbon single bond, and each carbon atom we have 3 hydrogen. We know carbon is what? Carbon is tetravalent, right? So each carbon atom must have 4 bonds, right? So one carbon atom contains 3 hydrogen, and both carbon atoms are attached to each other by a single bond, right? So this one is dash formula. Dash formula of propane is what? All these are hydrogen. This is the dash formula of propane. Correct. Next, write down the second one. Condensed formula. Condensed formula. Condensed formula of ethane, if I write down this one. In this, we do not represent carbon-hydrogen bond. Carbon-hydrogen bond we do not represent, okay? So we'll write this part as CH3. Carbon-carbon bond we'll have here, again CH3. This is condensed formula of ethane. Okay? Similarly, the condensed formula of propane is what? CH3, CH2, CH3. So we don't represent carbon-hydrogen bond in this formula, okay? The third and the last representation we have, that is bond line structure.
So under condensed formula, do we have to write H3C for the first thing, or can we write CH3?
We can write, carbon attached with carbon, right? So it's better to write H3C. If you write CH3 also, it's not wrong. Here you see, this means what? This hydrogen and carbon is not attached. Carbon and carbon bond is there. That's why we write H3C. But if you write this one also, it's fine.
So could I say CH2, CH3 whole twice?
CH2?
CH2 bonded to CH3 whole twice.
You can say that. You can write on this one. CH2, CH3 whole twice. Like this you can write. But this is not condensed formula. Okay, in condensed formula, carbon-carbon bond we show. Carbon-hydrogen bond we don't represent. But this is also same thing. It means this CH2 has 2 methyl group attached. Okay, bond line structure. Bond line structure of, suppose I am taking butane. Butane has 4 carbon, right? Bond line structure of butane is this. This is bond line structure of butane. Okay, zigzag. Because each carbon atom is sp3 hybridized, so you cannot write, it is not a straight chain. Carbon-carbon bond always is exact bond we have, right? All these corners, this point, this point, and these points are carbon, right? So in this representation, we don't show carbon and hydrogen bond, okay? It is understood that one carbon can have maximum 4 bonds. So this carbon attached with this carbon with one single bond, it means we have 3 hydrogen present here, right? How many hydrogen we have here?
2.
How many hydrogen here? 2, and here we have 3. So in this structure, we don't show carbon-hydrogen bond. Okay, it's just a line we draw. For, this is also, if you write down, 2-methyl-propane, this is also a condensed formula. The name of this compound is 2-methyl. You've done this chapter in the school?
Yeah. We started.
We'll see how to write down these names. Okay, we'll see one by one. But this is again, this corner is one carbon, this corner is one carbon, this is one carbon, and this is another carbon. Right? 2-methyl-propane. Okay. Classification of compounds, organic compounds. Open chain or cyclic compounds. Okay, open chain compounds we also call it as acyclic. Okay, open chain we also call it as acyclic. Acyclic and open chain are same thing. Open chain, then we have 2 types, saturated and unsaturated. Any example of saturated compound? The general thing is alkane. Alkane is a saturated compound. Okay? Unsaturated are all those compounds which contains multiple bonds, right? That is alkene and alkyne. Alkene and alkyne. What is the general formula of alkane? CnH2n plus 2 for alkene and for alkyne minus 2n minus 2. This is the classification. Cyclic compounds, we have two types. One is homocyclic and other one is heterocyclic. Homocyclic compounds are those compounds in which we have only one type of atom present in the ring. All atoms are same, so homocyclic. Okay, we'll see some examples into this. Okay, homocyclic compounds, then we have two types. Achha, we'll see for example of this. What is the example of homocyclic? Benzene. Heterocyclic, any example? Aniline we cannot say. Pyridine you can say, furan you can say, okay? So write down the example of heterocyclic compound, pyridine. Right? Pyridine, the example is what? The structure is this. This nitrogen present and alternate double bond. This is pyridine.
Why is
an aniline
hydrolyzed?
It has it outside the
ring. It is outside the ring. Okay. Homocyclic and heterocyclic. These are of again two types. It can be aromatic or alicyclic. Aromatic, we have two types again, benzenoid and non-benzenoid. Benzenoid and non-benzenoid, all these are not that important. The only thing is aromatic compounds are those compounds which has cyclic structure and 4n plus 2 pi electron conjugated system. Okay, so it can be benzenoid. Benzene means which has the structure of benzene. Like we have discussed anthracene, right? Anthracene has one benzene structure, right? So those are benzenoid compounds. Non-benzenoid also we have. For example, tropylium cation is a non-benzenoid compound, right? Aromatic but non-benzenoid. There's no benzene structure in it. Okay. So these are the classification of organic compounds we have. Understood?
The heterocyclic can be aromatic or anthracene.
Huh. Awesome.
Sir, what's the example for non-benzene?
Non-benzenoid is this. There's no benzene structure. This non-benzene, right? Alicyclic compounds are those compounds in which we have cyclic structure. Suppose we have this structure and some chain also we have. Some chain also present into this apart from. Means alicyclic plus cyclic, both structures. Okay? That is alicyclic compound. Okay? We have a side chain plus ring structure. That is alicyclic compound. Okay.
Can a heterocyclic thing be benzenoid?
Huh, possible. Furan is in heterocyclic, what do you say? Heterocyclic benzenoid.
Be benzenoid.
No, aromatic can be benzenoid. Heterocyclic also benzenoid possible. So means pyridine.
What's the name of that?
This is tropylium cation. Tropylium. L-I-U-M. Tropylium cation. Pyridine is also benzenoid structure, no? It is benzene kind of structure, heterocyclic, possible.
Means
okay.
So benzene structure only means there are six atoms and there are double bonds. It doesn't have to be carbon, all of the.
Yes, so if you replace this nitrogen atom by carbon, it is a benzene structure. So it is similar to benzene structure, that is benzenoid.
If there are two atoms that aren't carbon, it's still a benzene structure.
Yes.
So it's just the hexagonal alternating double bonds.
Yes. Means anthracene structure is what? You see this?
So even the inorganic benzene would be a benzene.
You can see. Benzene. This is also anthracene. benzenoid structure. You see, this is also similar to benzenoid structure. Okay? So we'll see the nomenclature one by one. The first one we'll see the nomenclature. See, one thing you see, why alkanes are said to be saturated compounds? There is no addition reaction possible. Because saturation means what? Carbon has already four bonds present here. Right? So, further addition on this carbon is not possible. Carbon cannot show pentavalency. Okay? But if you have an alkene, suppose C double bond C, and it has two double bond, then an electrophile attack onto this carbon, then this carbon shift onto this carbon atom, this pair of electrons. Right? So this kind of addition reaction is possible in unsaturated compound, right? Alkene or alkyne. That's why these compounds are unsaturated addition reaction possible in terms. Understood? Right? That's why alkene are said to be saturated, but alkenes and alkynes are unsaturated compounds.